Hello everyone, I'm Mac and today I want to talk about the Chrome device management licenses. I've seen a lot of concerns in this regard and I just want to explain what they are and how they work. Chrome device management licenses. There are two types of these licenses, perpetual and annual licenses. Let's talk about the annual licenses first. As per the Google Apps Help Center article, an annual license is both per term and can be renewed when the term ends. If you encounter a hardware issue and need to replace a device, you can transfer the license to a device of any model in the same domain. If you purchase additional annual licenses mid-term, the cost is prorated and the license expires at the same time as your original subscription. In other words, if you have an annual license, you can deprovision and enroll as many Chrome devices as you want. And if you purchase new licenses at the middle of the term, you will pay only a prorated amount to match the end of the original subscription. For example, let's say that the Chrome licenses cost $50 and you have purchased 5 licenses on January 1st. You pay the full price, $250, because they are the first one you have purchased for your domain. And on July or June middle year, you need to purchase one extra license. In this case, you will not pay the full $50, but you will pay only the remaining of the annual commitment, which is around 6 months, and it will be half of the original price, around $25. Now, let's talk about the perpetual licenses. As per the same Google Apps Help Center article, a perpetual subscription is only available for Chrome device management licenses and covers the life of the device it's enrolled to. If you encounter a hardware issue and need to replace a device with a perpetual license, you can transfer the license to another device of the same model or equivalent manufacturer-provided replacement. However, you cannot transfer the license from one device model to another, or to a device in another domain. Transfers are audited. We recommend reviewing the end-of-life policies for each device before purchasing a perpetual license. In other words, if you purchase a perpetual license, you will enroll Chrome devices and you will be able to use them as long as the life of the device ends. You don't need to worry about paying for a license renewal. With this type of licenses, since they don't have an end date or renewal date, you will pay the full price every time you need a new one. There are some things to keep in mind about the perpetual licenses. 1. You can reuse the licenses with a different device only if a manufacturer or reseller provides you a replacement device while still under the device warranty, and you will have to use the same model replacement as a deprovision reason. 2. Google is always auditing all deprovisions and enrollments. And if you are using a perpetual license incorrectly, you could get all your licenses cancelled. Let me answer some frequently asked questions. What happens if I need to replace a device that is using a perpetual license? If the replacement is a replacement to honor the device warranty, you can reuse the license. But if a replacement is just because you want to change it to a new model, you will have to purchase a new license for it. What happens if on my company I have perpetual and annual licenses? In this case, let me tell you that the Google Admin Console will not distinguish between annual or perpetual licenses. You will just have a pool of licenses ready to be used for your Chromebook devices. If, for example, I have 5 perpetual licenses and 5 annual licenses, how do I assign them to my devices? It's not possible to select which license will be assigned to a Chrome device at the enrolling process. As I said before, the Admin Console does not distinguish between annual or perpetual licenses. But how do I know which device has a perpetual license and which device has an annual license? You cannot tell which device has a specific type of license. Remember that I just mentioned, the Google Admin Console does not distinguish between the licenses. It will just take one available license and will assign it to the next device you enroll. Now, what will happen in this case? If you have 5 perpetual licenses and 5 annual, this means after a year from the date of purchase of the annual licenses, 5 licenses out of 10 that you have in total will expire. What do you need to do? Well, simple. You will need to decide which devices will no longer be in use on your company, school, or whatever you have, and deprovision them. The other 5 devices will keep working with no problems. But what happens if I do not deprovision the devices in time? Well, in this case, you will have restricted access to your account management until you deprovision the same amount of devices as licenses that has expired on your domain. The Admin Console will give you the following message: you have more devices enrolled than licenses on your domain. But if I also have kiosk licenses? These licenses are designed to be used by devices on kiosk mode only running signage content. Google recommends to have an organizational unit with all these devices in kiosk mode. And as well, Google also audits these licenses. If they detect that you have a kiosk license but you are running a device in regular Chrome OS license, you can get the licenses suspended waiting for you to deprovision those devices using the licenses incorrectly. Is it possible to move Chrome licenses to a different domain? As per the Google Help Center article, if your organization's network domain changes, all existing licenses can be redistributed from the old domain to the new one. Contact Google for Work Support for assistance. It also says, in general, all licenses must be transferred to the new domain. Google does not allow partial redistributions. In other words, you can move licenses from domain A to domain B, but you need to be aware of the following considerations. Number 1. Google can move Chrome device management licenses in specific orders only if the orders has less than 30 days from the purchase date. Number 2. You are not allowed to move one license from a order, unless the order has only one license on it. Number 3. If all your orders were purchased more than 30 days ago, the only option to move them will be to move all the licenses from domain A to domain B. If you want to move licenses, you can only move Chrome device management licenses to a different domain. And you can only move an entire order if it has less than 30 days from the purchase date. Or you will have to move all the licenses attached to the domain. If you want to know how do we know all this information, well, I just called Google Support. At the description, you will find all the Google Help Center articles that I used for this video. If you like this video, please share it with your friends on your social networks. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos like this. To contact me, please add yourself to my social networks by liking my Facebook page, following me on Twitter, and going to my blog. On the description, you will find these direct links. I'm Mac, and I wish you a great day.